My story about his daughter, she posed nude in Playboy.
I remember that.
Make her father crazy. And she came on the show a bunch of times to promote the issue. And at the end of the year, Playboy had a huge party. And I was co-hosting with Jenny McCarthy. And on the way to the city, I knew there was going to be X amount of semi-celebrities there. So I wrote a little something about Patti Davis Reagan and about Gilbert Gottfried, about Grandpa Al Lewis, and whoever else was there. There was like five or six semi-whatever. And we get to this Wilbur Hall, I think it was, or whatever it's called. And it was like every Playboy party, they invite every male in Manhattan. And they say, you're invited to a VIP party. So there's like 600 guys and three women, and it's just a shit show. So before, we're down below, and my friend Eric is doing a thing called Hot Takes. Do you remember there was a Playboy show on cable that was, it was the video, the music videos that were too dirty or too hot for MTV. And Jenny was the host of that. And that's why we were doing this thing upstairs together. So I'm down there and we're doing the interstitials. So at one point in between, I said, listen, I wrote a great joke on the way in here, but I'm not sure about it. And I told her the joke and she roared. She said, do that when we come back on camera. I said, you sure? And the guy's the cameraman. They're, yeah, that's a killer. So we came back and I told the joke and we all laughed our asses off. We walked to go into what was called the VIP bar, but it was all the same. And the doors open. And I'm nose to nose with Patti Davis and Jenny and the Playmate of the Year. And, you know, I said, Patti, it's so nice to see you. You know, I wrote a joke about you on the way in here. And I told her the joke. And as I'm just getting to the end of the joke, I realized that your joke was funny to every person in the world except her. Because I didn't know that they had made, and her face went white, and she went off on me, and flash bulbs are flapping, and it was just insane. I'd never talk so. Hey, oh geez, I'm sorry. I didn't. Blah, 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 blah. It's Thursday night. Friday morning, we come on the air, and nothing happens. I'm like, thank God I skated, you know, because that could have been crap. Meanwhile, fucking the show. It was 10 o'clock on a Thursday night. Of course, it wasn't in the paper on Friday. I live on Long Island. I'm a drunk. I'm not paying attention to the New York Post. I come in to work on Monday morning, and the mics go on, and Robin goes, he did it again, Howard. And Howard says, what? He insulted the president's daughter. And then they start saying, you know, yeah, you know, it's in the Post that Jackie upset Patti Davis Reagan and blah, blah, blah. And they start berating me. And after 5 or 10 minutes, Gary comes in. He says, hey, Howard, the listeners are all calling in, Howard. They all want to hear the joke that he told her. And he says, all right, Jackie, tell your joke. So I told the joke. And I'm telling you, Howard was biting his lip. And the joke was, hey, Patti, I heard you were the first person to know that your father had Alzheimer's disease because he started returning your phone calls. And it was just so hysterical. And they're biting their lips and they're trying to insult me and tell me how rude and inappropriate I am. And meanwhile, everybody's dying. It's the funniest joke they ever heard. So that, and that went on for a whole day. And the next day she called up the show and started in on me. And to me, it was still funny. And I just laughed through the whole time. And I got her, Howard, Robin, they're all attacking me. I'm like, you're all so full of crap.